Catch. Hold the right leg. Bring the heel closer to the body. Turn the shoulder blade towards left leg. So make it perpendicular to the left leg. Inhale, both hands up. Exhale, bend forward. Keeping the left knee straight. Try to bring forehead closer to the left knee. Tuck the stomach in. Inhale, come back. We'll do one more time, longer duration. You can inhale, exhale while in a pose. Each time exhale, push the head closer towards the knee. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale, come back up. Keeping the left leg as is, just the right leg, hold it outward and push the knee away. Trunk straight. We'll bring the left palm on the right knee, right hand, right palm go at the back of the body, exhale and look back. Okay, inhale, come back up. Now both hands on one side, on left side, outward of the left leg, both palms on the floor and look towards back while exhale. And then try to bring forehead closer to the floor. You can touch the floor with the forehead, but don't let the other knee lift. Okay, inhale, come back up. Now bring the left hand forward. And in the same way, like keeping the palm up, with the thumb and first finger, grab the big toe on left. Inhale, raise the right hand up. Exhale, bend the whole trunk toward the left and try to bring the right hand onto the left toe. So with both hands, grab the left toe and keep looking at the ceiling. If you cannot reach the left toe, you can just go as far as possible. Okay, inhale, come back up, straighten the right leg, hold the left leg, the left heel all the way closer to the body, turn the shoulder blade towards the right leg, inhale, raise both hands up, look up, exhale, put bend from the lower back, try to bring forehead closer to the right knee, keeping the right knee straight. Hold in a pose for a few seconds. Inhale, come back. We'll do one more time, longer duration. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Back up. Hold the left leg outside, outward. Right palm on the left knee. Left palm at back of the body. Exhale and look back. You can align the chin with the left shoulder. can feel the twist on the spine at midpoint. Inhale, come back to center. Bring both palms on the right side. Exhale, turn toward back, look at the back. And then try to bring the forehead closer to the floor between both the palms. Okay. The right hand, grab the left toe. Inhale, raise the left hand up over the head. Exhale. Bend the trunk toward the right foot. Bring the left hand, join the right hand on the right toe. Keep looking up. Inhale, come back up. Both legs straight. We'll do grinding pose. Make the fist up. Interlock the fingers. Both elbows straight, knee straight. Start the palms hovering around over the toes and the knee. Big circle. You can inhale when you go back. Exhale when you bend forward. 4 to 5 circles in each direction. You can close the eyes and keep awareness on the pelvis area, hip joints, and see how the stretch move from one side to other side as we rotate. Grinding pose, Chakki Talanasana. Okay, once we grinded enough, relax both legs together. We'll do Purva Uttanasana. So you can do halfway, you can just hold both the hands, you can bring elbows on the floor, push toes outward, drop the head at the back of the body, and push the lower back up. Or you can do, bring both the palms at the back. Inhale, lift the whole body, whole trunk up. Push the toes down to the floor. Drop the head at the back of the body. And very slowly bring the body back to the floor. That was Purva Uttanasana, backward bending. Next we'll do complementary pose for that. So Purva Uttanasana and Paschima Uttanasana, complementary to each other. So you can do either one first, and then you can do the second one. Inhale, raise both hands up, both feet together. Exhale, bend from the lower back, push the trunk forward, and try to grab the toes or feet. Keep holding the pressure as far as you can reach. Inhale, both hands up. One more time. Exhale, bend forward and grab the feet. Okay. Fold one leg. Whichever side is folded, bring that side hand at back of the body. Other hand will go around the knee. Exhale and turn towards back. Okay, very gently switch to the other side. Vakrasana. Okay. Back to Gomukhasana. Well, we had a senior session last week, and Bhagwan Uncle volunteered to say all the chakra names and how to activate. And he demoed some of the poses for each of the chakra on activating them, like one or two poses for each chakra. So all of these poses is basically directly affect the chakra too. Gomukhasana, bring the knees on top of each other, heels, side of the body, but very close. Whichever knee is up, raise that hand up. Other hand will go back of the body. You can interlock the fingers, the palm, connect them together. Once you get connected, then correct the posture. Look straight, trunk straight. This point, you can even close the eyes and scan the body. See, currently we are feeling that we're sitting on mat or floor, whatever floor we are on. We feel the connection and just part by part, quickly go upward all the way to the head. Okay, release the hands and switch to the other side. Okay, release the hands. So one request, when we write the names on our screen, we better put last name as well, because so many of the names, we have multiple people. So we don't know who are there actually. So just don't forget to put your last name as well. Okay, next, let's sit in Vajrasana. Keep the knees few inches apart, sit on the heels. We will do Mandukasana frog pose, extend both hands forward, make a tight fist, thumb inside, deeply inhale and hold the breath in lower abdomen. Put the top of the fist slightly over the navel, forcefully exhale, don't leave the heels and bend forward. When you can no longer bend down, you can tilt the head slightly up so you can see a few inches ahead of you. and observe the continuous pressure. Inhale, come back up. Observe continuous pressure at the navel, the Manipura chakra. We'll do one more time, more effectively. Okay. Next, we'll do backward bending. We'll do Supta Vajrasana. So stay in the Vajrasana pose to begin with. Bring both hands at the back. If you are able to do Supta Vajrasana fully, you can do halfway. You can fold both the hands, elbows rest on the floor, drop the head at the back of the body, and relax the lower back. And make sure knees touching the floor. You can stay in this pose, or if you're able to, slide both hands forward and let the whole body completely lay down on the floor. The back of the head is on the floor, the whole back rested on the floor. You can even raise both hands up. You can place the palms over the thigh and knees touching the floor too. You can close the eyes. You can quickly scan the body to observe any stretches, any feeling, any pressure. So whenever you need to come up, just grab both the ankles, push the elbows down to the floor, and push the whole body up, back to Vajrasana. So keep the knee about 1 to 1.5 foot apart. Hold the left hand and bring the elbow between the knee, the left elbow between the knee. And make a fist of the left hand. Make a fist on right hand as well. Inhale, look toward the ceiling and fold the right hand at back of the body. So both hands, fist. Exhale, come down, forehead on the left hand. Inhale, look up, look toward the ceiling, and even push the right shoulder further back. Exhale, go down, do 5 more times. Inhale, up, expand the chest sideways. Exhale, down. And relax, come back up. So you can, when you make a fist, you can tightly, you can make the tight fist, that power up, the boost the power. And we'll do the other side. Okay, if you forgot counting, you can stop now. So about 5 to 7 times. Next, bring both palms on the floor, elbows straight, Keep walking, the hand walking forward, few inches at a time, and let the body roll down onto the floor. You might separate the knees a little bit further. Try to accommodate the whole trunk. Bring chin, chest to the floor, or you can bring forehead to the floor. Relax the shoulders, trunk, and the lower back. And in this position, deeply inhale, deeply exhale. And you will notice at least the breathing capacity, probably 10 to 20%, you will notice that you will be able to breathe extra air in. Start the hands, keep bringing towards the body, and let the head and trunk go up. Don't try to pull the body up, just let it go up itself as we bring the hands back. Okay, stand on the knee. We'll do half camel pose, both palms, both hands at the hip joint, fingers pointing down, the knees and feet separated same as the shoulder width. Look straight, inhale, start turning the head up, look up, and try to look all the way back. Keep pushing the elbows closer to each other and keep pushing the pelvis area forward. When I do countdown, you should hold all three forces at your maximum. Keep pushing the trunk forward, the pelvis area forward. Keep dropping the head back and keep pushing the elbows toward closer. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And release the hands. Straighten the trunk up, vertical posture. Bend forward. And try to bring the left hand toward the right side and the left side of the face on the floor. Right hand go up. You can hold it at the back of the body and look up towards the ceiling. You can push the left palm down to the floor. So it will give us a good twist toward the ceiling. Okay, bring the right palm on the floor and both palms on the floor again. And bring the right hand, slide over to the left side, the right side of the face on the floor, left hand up the back of the body, and look toward the ceiling. Okay, come back. Okay, stay in a tabletop pose. We'll do cat and cow pose, Marjari Asana. Inhale, look up. In the mid back, will go down. You're going to make arch, downward arch. Exhale, look down. Try to make the spine upward arch. Do 5 more times. Inhale up. Exhale down. Do the best attempt to make upward arch and downward arch. Okay. Come back up again on the knees and feet separated correctly. We will do full camel pose. Inhale, the circular fashion, bring one hand up, exhale, and land on the same side on the heels. Inhale, the other hand up, exhale, the palms, both the palms on corresponding heels. Keep dropping the head at the back and keep pushing the pelvis forward. Hold the pose. You can breathe in and out. With the countdown, you can do the best effort to hold the pose. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Very slowly come out of the pose, one hand at a time. And bring both palms on the floor. We'll do tiger pose. Extend the right leg back, toes stretch out. Inhale, exhale, normal. The leg parallel to the floor. With next inhalation, bend the leg at the knee. Don't drop the knee. Knee still remain at the level, hip level. You can look around and make sure the leg is not tilting. Left, right, is not dropping. And once you make correction, just come back, look up, relax the lower back. You can inhale, exhale, normal. With next exhalation, lower the leg. Bring the right knee down to the floor. Join with the left knee. With next inhalation, extend. The left leg at the back, parallel to the floor, toes straight out. Inhale, exhale, normal. With next inhalation, bend the leg at the left knee. Correct the posture. Relax the lower back and look up straight. With next exhalation, bring the left knee down to the floor. And we are again back to sitting in a Vajrasana. So let's talk something related to yoga, Ayurveda, something. Do anybody have anything in mind to talk something and some anything?
Bakul bhai, talk about Makar Sankranti.
Okay, go ahead.
Oh no, not me, you.
Yeah, Bakul bhai, I have one point.
Okay.
Go ahead. One time we were doing a Mandukasana.
Uh-huh.
And our teacher is in the South India.
Uh-huh.
But how things relate all over India, that's, I want to bring the point.
Okay.
So I felt the pulse in naval area.
Uh-huh.
So I asked him a question. Okay, what is that? So he said, you ever heard about the pituitary? I said, yes. He said, is the pulse in the center? That means your pituitary in the center. If it is your pulse, you feel off center. That means it's moved. Then you have a health problem. So you better bring it in the center. And I, whoever is a village, we know that we used to do that, right?
Yes.
Yeah, that's, I want to bring that point to you.
Yeah. So, yeah. And also there is the solar chakra, right? The solar energy.
Yeah.
The naval chakra.
What I'm saying is, in Saurashtra, we have that. But that in South India, same thing. That's what I'm saying. So it's a, it's kind of our Ayurveda probably spread around.
It is part of the Ayurveda, yes. And we know that આપણે ગુજરાતીમાં પેસુટી ખસી ગઈ કે છે એ લોકો આમ એની મોબિલિટી ઓછી થઈ જતી હોય છે પછી આવીને એને મસાજ કરીને સ્પેશિયલ એના જાણકાર હોય એનો હે કેન જસ્ટ બ્રિંગ ઇટ બેક
યસ
તો એન્ડ પ્લસ વોટએવર વી ડુ ઉત્તાન પાદાસન કે આપણે આપણે લે ડાઉન હોય અને બેવ લેગને 90 ડિગ્રી અપ કરીએ છીએ ને ઉત્તાન પાદાસન ધેટ ઓલસો ફિક્સિસ ધ સોલર પ્લેક્સિસ એન્ડ ધ અંડર ધ થિંગ Yeah, but regarding, thank you, Chaturbhai.
You're welcome.
And yeah, another, since you're talking about Mandukasana, another main reason we're doing Mandukasana is, so that's, there is the pancreas that get activated. That's why that asana is recommended for the diabetic people. For Makar Sankranti, you know, there are nationwide, it's everywhere when you go north to south, it's probably 10 different culture, even including Nepal has different thing too, but they all has their own culture-wise different name and different purpose, but they all celebrate that. And another, there are several stories behind that, right? We know that regarding the Bhishma Pitamah, he just left his body on that day.
Can I say
something? Who was that? Oh, sorry. I accidentally mute you. I thought you were... Okay,
Rina,
go ahead.
Rina, can I say something for the Makar Sankranti?
Yes.
Okay. Makar means Uttar. And Dhanur Rasi Mathi, Makar Ma Surya Narayan Pravesh Kare Chhe, which is Dhanur Rasi means Dhanur is Dakshin. Dakshin Mathi Uttar Tarap Surya Narayan Pravesh Uttarayan Kare, Ayan Kare means ઉત્તરાયણ કરે છે એટલે ઉત્તરમાં જાય છે દક્ષિણમાંથી પૂર્વ ઉત્તર તરફ એટલે ધેટ્સ કોલ્ડ ઉત્તરાયણ એટલે ધનુર્માસ પૂરો થયો અને ઉત્તરમાં પ્રવેશ કર્યો સૂર્યનારાયણ દેવે એટલે ધેટ્સ કોલ્ડ ઉત્તરાયણ અને મકર સંક્રાંતિ એટલે મકર સંક્રાંતિ મીન્સ સૂર્યનારાયણ આઈ મીન ઓલ ધ દેવો બધા દેવોનો સૂર્ય ગઈકાલે મકર સંક્રાંતિ ને દિવસે આયન થાય મીન્સ ઉગે છે એટલે સૂર્ય બધા દેવોને માટે મકર સંક્રાંતિ ને દિવસે ઉગે છે એટલા માટે એને મકર સંક્રાંતિ કહે છે
રાઈટ ગુડ એટલે બેઝ ઓન ધ થીમ ઓલસો ધેર આર નેમ ઉત્તરાયણ એવરીથિંગ રાઈટ યપ ગ્રેટ ઓકે સો સિન્સ વી ટોકિંગ અબાઉટ આયુર્વેદા થિંગ very interesting question, and I think probably ladies might be jump into this to giving the answer, I guess. According to Ayurveda, how many tests that our tongue can do? Like ketla test, chapra, swan, type of test. Nilamben, you are not qualified. You are all qualified. I will hold you. Let other answer and then your turn at the last.
Okay, six tests,
I said you are overqualified to answer this. I said you hold on to that, let other answer, and if not answer, you can answer.
Sorry.
You are already overqualified. You are Ayurveda Acharya. Mm-hmm.
Bakulbhai, six basic tests, but our tongue can recognize thousands of tests.
Okay, yep. So six basic tests, kaya kaya? Can
khato kharo, turo, galyo, tikho. Khato kharo, galyo, tikho.
Tame main
kadu kya? Kadu. Kadu, kadu.
Kadu. Okay. Bitter. Yeah. Good. Now I will let Nilamben talk about, because there might be Sanskrit names too. Yes, Nilamben. Sorry, I hold you. Now. There was a reason, because I know you know the answer. So I will just hold you. Yeah, you have a unmute karo. Oh, he's not there, I guess. Okay. All right. So the reason bringing up that point is because each of the tests, any sathe pacha connection chhe apne direct vat pit kapna. And apna je panch tattvo chhe, kema pachu dakla tarike apne ke ek bhai tikhu. To tikhu atle ye prakruti je chhe apne je khaiye chhe. To ye siddhu kone asar kare? To ye asar kare apne air and fire element. And every nani jore yaku, this whole thing is connected for the test and what pit and the imbalance things. Namate apne ayurveda tarie paha jaye to apne ghani vakat apne food ma etla mate kahi de che ke tamare aa prakruti aavi che tame amuk food tikhu vadhare khavu ke galu vadhare khavu, generally balance karva mate apne joye che dish ni andar lagbhag badhi vastu apne cover karva try kariye che ek dish ma, apne ek meal hoy to eni andar lagbhag badha test cover karva try kariye che.
મધુર અમલ લવણ તિક્ત કટુ કસાઈ સિક્સ રસ એટલે એના ઉપરથી આખો શ્લોક મને શ્લોક નથી યાદ પણ એટલે મધુર એટલે મીઠો અમ્લ એટલે ખાટો લવણ એટલે ખારો કટુ તિક્ત અને કસાય કટુ એટલે તીખો અને તિક્ત એટલે કડવો એન્ડ કસાય લાઈક કટુ તિક્ત કસાય એટલે તુરો એટલે એ છ રસ હોય છે એટલે આપણે એકચ્યુઅલી આપણી લાઈફમાં એવરી ડે સિક્સ રસનું સેવન કરવું જોઈએ દેટ્સ વી આયુર્વેદા સે આપણે વધારે મધુર કે બધો રસ મધુર લેવો જોઈએ બધા છ રસ લેવા જોઈએ અને આપણે રેગ્યુલર લાઈફમાં બધા ડિઝર્ટમાં આઈ મીન ડિનર કે લંચ કરે પછી ડિઝર્ટ સ્વીટ રસ લેતા હોય છે રાઈટ બટ એકચ્યુઅલી આયુર્વેદા સેઝ ઇઝ યુ કેન મધુર રસ જયમાં પહેલા લેવાનું પછી જમવાનું એમ ધેટ્સ વે ઇઝ વર્ક મોર બેટર ફોર ધ ડાયજેશન સો એન્ડ ઓલસો
લાડુ આપી રસ્તા
એટલે તમને બધાને યાદ હોય તો મને યાદ છે અમે હું નાની હતી ત્યારે દ્વારકામાં અમે રહેતા તો પછી ત્યાં ધજા ચડાવે ને તો એ ઘુઘરી બ્રાહ્મણ ને એ બધા જમવાનું કરતા હોય તો અમે લોકો ત્યારે એમની યારે કનેક્ટ હતા એટલે જતા તો પહેલા ત્યાં બુંદીના લાડવા જ ખાવા આપે પછી દાળ ભાજા એન્ડ યા એટલે ઈ ટાઈપનું હતું ઈ વખતે એમ
ના ના એટલે જ તે આપણે તમે લગ્ન પ્રસંગમાં જોવો ને પહેલા બધા એ મીઠાઈ પીરસવા નીકળતા લાડવા ભટકા બરફી બધું
બધાને ખબર નથી હોતી બટ લોટ થિંગ ઇઝ કનેક્ટેડ વિથ આયુર્વેદા એવરીથિંગ
યસ થેન્ક યુ નિલમબેન સો યા ધેટ વોઝ ધ પોઈન્ટ કે આયુર્વેદા યોગા ધીસ ઇઝ ઓલ રિલેટેડ
Because and yoga is also yoga is came from the Ayurveda too. Yoga is not separate from the Ayurveda. It came from Ayurveda.
Ayurveda it came from Atharva Veda.
Yeah, right.
And yoga it came from Rig Veda. But this is all basically in the same root. And all our cultures everywhere, overall India, everywhere we go north to south, east west. But all the culture have some kind of essence from, like derived from it. But day by day, everything got changed. We are just trying nowadays to get back, whatever we are. So great, there was good discussion. Let's move ahead and stand up. પછી મને ખબર તમને વાતો ચડાવી દેવું ને આસન નહીં કરવા હોય એટલે ઓકે બોથ ફીટ ટુગેધર ગો ઓન ધ ટોઝ ઇન્ટરલોક ધ પામ્સ યુ કેન ટર્ન અપસાઇડ ડાઉન એક્ચ્યુઅલી આપણે ગ્રુપમાં બે બીએમએસ છે નીલમબેન અને પ્રફુલ પ્રફુલ દેવાણી આપણે પાસે એલોપેથી ડોક્ટર હોય છે આયુર્વેદાચાર્ય હોય છે ઓકે એક્સેલ કમ બેક વીલ ડુ વન મોર ટાઈમ એન્ડ વીલ ડુ મલ્ટીપલ અપ એન્ડ ડાઉન ઇનહેલ રેઝ ધ હેલ્સ અપ એક્સેલ બ્રિંગ ધ હેલ્સ ડાઉન ઇનહેલ અપ એક્સેલ ડાઉન થ્રી મોર ટાઈમ્સ ઓલ ધ વે અપ એન્ડ વેન યુ ગો અપ સ્ટ્રેચ ધ હોલ બોડી અપ And last time. Okay. Let's walk on the toes. Make a two circle. And then walk on heels. Next, Kati Chakrasan waist rotation. Separate the legs far apart. Palms at the waist. Exhale. Turn towards one side. Look all the way back. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, and other side. Okay, one more time, both sides. Okay, inhale, raise one hand up. Exhale, bend towards the other side. The other hand will go along with the leg. Keep looking toward the ceiling and keep bending down as much as you can. Try to keep body in one plane. That means you're not going to like bend forward too much. Inhale, come back up. So try to stay in same plane. And as far as down you can go. Okay. Do one more time on both sides. Keep looking towards the ceiling. And the other side. Both hands parallel to the shoulder. Inhale, turn towards left. Exhale, bring the right hand, grab the left toe. And the other hand will go 90 degree up. So basically it will be pointing to the corner of the ceiling and look through those fingers. Inhale, come back. And other side. Exhale, bend down. One more time, same pose. So basically both hands will go 90 degree when we just bend down. And look through the fingers of the hand which is up in air. Okay. विल डू एक्सटेंशन ऑफ दिस पोज परिवृत्त त्रिकोणासन. दिस टाइम वी विल ब्रिंग हैंड्स आउटवर्ड ऑफ द एंकल एंड अदर हैंड विल गो वर्टिकली अप टू द सीलिंग. विल बेंड फर्दर डाउन सो इट विल बी कन्वीनियंट फॉर अस टू लुक टुवर्ड द सीलिंग. Look at the thumb. Come back and other side. Okay. So, because of the Uttarayan, should we do 10 Surya Namaskar today? How many people agree? How many people okay to do 10 Surya Namaskar today? 2. 3. Oh, not too many people. We'll do 5. Okay. Turn the 1 foot 90 degree outward. The other foot will remain forward. Hold at the knee. Bring both hands down. First we'll do Virbhadrasana 1. Inhale, raise both hands up and bend towards back. The trailing leg will remain straight. Try to bring the body closer to the floor. As bent as possible. Very slowly switch to the other side. Virbhadrasana 1, also called warrior pose. There are 4 variations. So this is the first one. The second one, same feet position. We're going to extend both hands. There will be in a straight one line. And look through the fingers. We're going to chant 2 Gayatri Mantra. Om Bhurbhuvah Svah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhyo Yo Nah Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvah Svah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhyo Yo Nah Prachodayat. Okay. Om Bhurbhuvah Svah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yo Nah Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvah Svah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yo Nah Prachodayat. Okay, that was with Virbhadrasana 2. 3 and 4 of the Virbhadrasana are kind of balancing pose. So let's do 3. I'll show you the final posture if you don't remember. So final pose is this. So depends on how you get there. You can go straight just like this. Or if you have difficulty to coming into pose directly like this, you can bring both hands down to the floor first, extend the leg back, and then at the end, when you feel okay, that point you can raise both hands up. Or you can hold leg also just like this instead of holding the floor and keep the leg, other leg back. So that way you don't need to lift the hand so much. can do this way. Another great idea is, if you are still wondering what are the other options could be, so you can just raise both hands up, stand straight. That point, you can just start bending forward, keeping the leg also along with the body as a counterweight. So you can get into the pose too. So that's Virbhadrasana 3. Now you remember 1, 2, 3. And Virbhadrasana 4. 4 is also balancing pose. You can grab the ankle on the same side of the hand. Bend down, extend the hand forward, and pull the folded leg away from the body. You can pull the leg all the way up. And the other side. Yeah, I see so many people doing this pose very well now. If I look at 6 month old video, probably it was huge difference now and back then. Okay, I think first time we probably did all Virbhadrasana poses, otherwise do two and two next time, yeah, right? So let's move forward at the mat and just let it relax. Normal breathe in and out. Meantime, I will put the Surya Namaskar mantra. Just completely relax. Get ready for Surya Namaskar mantra.
Namaha. Om Mitraya. भानवे नमः
अर्काय नमः
ओम
खगाय नमः
was a five Surya Namaskar, 12 times five, so we got 60 poses. Let's sit down in Malasan. You can join the hands together, kick the knees outward. So I think 10 is doable too, sometime, someday. Okay, relax the hands. We can spread the one hand on one side and look through the palms as far as we can, bring it towards back and look through the palm. Bring the hand back and the other side. You can point toward the corner of the ceiling or toward the back. Okay, let's do Vrikshasana. Okay, once you complete the Vrikshasana on both the sides, we'll do Paschim Namaskar, joining the hands at the back of the body. Start at the lower back and let the fingertip touch first, then you can push them upward. They will go all the way back, and then you can push the elbows towards back. And relax. Let's lay down before we run out time so much. Let's lay down on the stomach. Extend both hands forward. Both the leg and toes stretch outward toward the back wall. Inhale, exhale. With next inhalation, raise the hands, head, chest up, and pull both legs up, thighs over the floor. And hold there, then bring them down. and lay down in Makarasana. Whenever you are in a relaxing pose like Makarasana, just let the whole bodily tension go. Don't hold any muscle, any body part. Let it be relaxed. Okay, bring both hands under the chin, like you know, kids watching the TV. Just pretend that we are watching the TV, and what else they do? They can fold the legs, right? Try to bring the heel closer to the hip, or you can kick with the both legs together. At the same time, you should relax the lower back. This is very good for the back pain. Again, bring the chin, head back to the body, legs straight. We'll do Ardha Shalabhasana. Lift the one leg up, hold the other leg to support it. Toes straight out, chest, chin, shoulder blade flat on the floor. Relax the lower back. And gently switch to the other side. Okay, bring both legs down, back to Makarasana for a few seconds. Next, we'll do Dhanurasana, bow pose. Hold both the legs, grab ankles, right to right, left to left. Inhale, raise chest, chin, head up, and pull both legs up. You can inhale, exhale. As we inhale, our stomach will be in flat. We'll just bring some movement. That's also good. Massage internal organs in stomach area. And bring both legs down. Let's turn around, lay down on the back, and straight get into the Shavasana and relax for a few seconds in Shavasana. Spread both the legs a couple feet apart as you feel comfortable. Toes pointing out, both hands away from the body, fingers semi-closed. Inhale, exhale, normal. Bring both hands closer to the body, both feet together. Extend the hands over the head, stretch, Ustrikasana. Stick pose, toes stretch out, hand stretch out from the opposite direction. Pretend that we are a rope and there are two separate forces pulling us away. Pull stretch. And release. Now bring both hands to the side of the body. 2 seconds, normal breathing. We'll do Naukasana. Raise both legs 30 degrees up over the floor. Trunk also 30 degrees over the floor. Raise both hands such a way that look toenail through the fingernails. very slowly bring the legs back, lay down in Shavasana. Then fold the right leg and with both the hands grab the lower leg and bring the knee closer to the face, closer to the chest. Raise the left leg up, straight up, 90 degree up, toes stretch out. Exhale, bring it down. Inhale, up. Keep holding the right leg at the chest. We're just doing up and down with the left leg only. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. One more time. Up and down. And bring it up, but making a circle. Make 5 circles in one direction. And then 5 circles in the reverse direction. Try to keep knee straight when you rotate the leg. Once you complete, relax the left leg completely, straighten the right leg, hold the left leg with both hands, bring the left knee towards the face of the chest and hold there. Inhale, raise the right leg up, exhale, down, 4 more times. Okay, and rotate. Keeping the knee straight, try to make biggest circle possible. Okay. Once completed, both legs straight, lay down in Shavasana, few seconds. Now bring both palms facing upside down next to the body to support the body. We'll do Uttan Padasana. Raise both legs up 90 degrees. Knee straight and hold the legs straight up. That's the one we talk about. Fix the solar plexus. It brings to the correct position. And in about 15 seconds, we will start lowering the legs, but we will do inch by inch. And start lowering the leg, no crash landing, very slowly. And relax completely. Both legs separated, toes pointing out, both hands far apart. In Shavasana, take rest a few seconds. Next, we will do Matsyasan. That can be done by everybody. There is no restriction. Both palms under the body, both legs together, toes stretch out. Inhale, lift the whole trunk up, the upper body up, keeping the trunk up, bring the top of the head at the floor. So look back wall and keep holding in a pose. Let the whole throat area, the thoracic region, let it be fully spread. That will be stay in that pose about 20 to 30 seconds. Meantime, I'll set up the Yog Nidra audio. Since we don't do any other inversions, or some people not able to do some inversions, we better do Matsyasana. And everyone should do Matsyasana. Because we want some energy, whatever we gain, it should flow back towards the head. So that's the best pose anybody can do. So in about less than 10 seconds, we'll start Yog Nidra. If you want to cover yourself, you want to turn the lights down or dim it, turn it off, whatever, but be completely comfortable. Okay, lay down in Shavasana, fully resting posture. Just follow the instructions and don't even move a little bit, not even just wiggling the finger, no. You just completely still, 100% still.
गहरी सांसें लेना शुरू करें। गहरी सांस अंदर और बाहर। एक बार फिर से गहरी सांस अंदर और बाहर। पुनः एक बार अंदर आती हुई सांस आपको ताजगी दे रही है, शक्ति दे रही है, और बाहर जाती हुई सांस आपके तनाव, टेंशन, तकलीफों को आपसे दूर ले जा रही है। और अब आपका मन शांत होने लगा है। आसपास के आवाजों के साक्षी बनिए, उनके साथ कोई लड़ाई नहीं करनी है, सिर्फ उनको सुनना है, एक साक्षी भाव। और अब धीरे धीरे आपका शरीर ढीला पड़ने लगा है, और ज्यों ज्यों आपका शरीर ढीला पड़ रहा है, आपका मन शांत होने लगा है। जो भी हो रहा है उसको होने दें, किसी भी अनुभव को जज ना करें। अपनी चेतना को अपने पैर की उंगलियों पे ले जाएं, लेफ्ट टोस एंड राइट टोस, उसको अपने मन की आंखों से देखें, महसूस करें और ढीला छोड़ें। अब अपने ध्यान को अपने दोनों एंकल्स या टखनों पे ले जाएं, एंकल में मौजूद तनाव को, टेंशन को महसूस करें और ढीला छोड़ें। दोनों टखने विश्राम कर रहे हैं। अब अपनी चेतना को धीरे से अपने दोनों पिंडलियों या काफ मसल्स पे ले जाएं। वहां की संवेदनाओं के साक्षी बनिए और धीरे से दोनों पिंडलियों को ढीला छोड़ें, शिथिल करें। आपके घुटने के नीचे का भाग शिथिल हो चुका है, ढीला हो चुका है, रिलैक्स हो चुका है। इस विश्राम को अपने अंदर अनुभव करिए। अपनी चेतना को अब अपने दोनों जांघों पर ले जाएं, लेफ्ट थाई एंड राइट थाई। वहां की मांसपेशियों को महसूस करें, वहां मौजूद टेंशन को, स्ट्रेस को देखें और ढीला छोड़ें। दोनों जांघ रिलैक्स हो चुके हैं, शिथिल हो चुके हैं। अब अपनी चेतना को दोनों कूल्हों के ऊपर ले जाएं, लेफ्ट हिप एंड द राइट हिप, एंड रिलैक्स द मसल्स ऑफ योर हिप्स एंड थाइस। कूल्हे की मांसपेशियां ढीली हो रही हैं, रिलैक्स हो रही हैं। अब अपनी चेतना को अपने पेट और कमर के निचले हिस्से पे ले जाएं, उसको महसूस करें, देखें और ढीला छोड़ें। अब अपनी चेतना को अपनी छाती पर लाइए, छाती की मांसपेशियों को ढीला छोड़ें, आराम दें, विश्राम दें। अपनी चेतना को पीठ के ऊपरी हिस्से पे लाइए, वहां मौजूद तनाव के साक्षी बने, उसको देखें और ढीला छोड़ें। पूरा शरीर ढीला हो रहा है, रिलैक्स्ड हो रहा है और आपका मन एक गहन विश्राम में उतरता चला जा रहा है। इस विश्राम के साक्षी बनिए। अब अपनी चेतना को अपने दोनों कंधे, लेफ्ट शोल्डर एंड द राइट शोल्डर पर लाएं। दोनों कंधे विश्राम कर रहे हैं, ढीले हो रहे हैं, रिलैक्स हो रहे हैं। अपने ध्यान को अब अपनी दाएं बांह और बाईं बांह के ऊपर ले जाएं। टेंशन ऑन लेफ्ट आर्म एंड राइट आर्म। देखें, महसूस करें, ढीला छोड़ें। हाथ की उंगलियों को भी ढीला छोड़ें, रिलैक्स करने दें और ज्यों ज्यों आपकी मांसपेशियां रिलैक्स कर रही हैं, आपका मन एक गहन विश्राम में, डीप रिलैक्सेशन में उतरता चला जा रहा है। अब अपने ध्यान को अपने गर्दन के ऊपर ले जाएं, गर्दन में मौजूद तनाव को, टेंशन को महसूस करें और गर्दन के रेशे रेशे को ढीला छोड़ें, आराम करने दें। आप एक गहन विश्राम में उतरते जा रहे हैं। जो विचार आए उन विचारों को आने दें, उससे कोई लड़ाई नहीं करनी, उससे कोई झगड़ा नहीं करना। अपनी चेतना को अपने चेहरे के ऊपर ले जाएं, दाईं आंख, बाईं आंख, ऊपर का होठ, नीचे का होठ, आपके गाल और संपूर्ण चेहरा, चेहरे के सारे मांसपेशियों को विश्राम करने दें, ढीला छोड़ें। और अब आप अपनी चेतना को सिर के पिछले हिस्से पे ले जाएं और सिर के पिछले हिस्से को पूरी तरह से ढीला छोड़ें, रिलैक्स करें। ज्यों ज्यों आपका शरीर रिलैक्स हो रहा है, आपका मन एक गहन विश्राम में उतरता चला जा रहा है। और ज्यों ज्यों आपका मन गहन विश्राम में जा रहा है, आपके शरीर की मांसपेशियां और शिथिल हो रही हैं और ढीली पड़ रही हैं। संपूर्ण बायां पैर शिथिल हो चुका है, संपूर्ण दायां पैर रिलैक्स्ड हो चुका है, ढीला पड़ चुका है। पेट छाती की मांसपेशियां आराम कर रही हैं, विश्राम कर रही हैं। संपूर्ण पीठ की मांसपेशियां ढीली पड़ रही हैं, रिलैक्स्ड पड़ रही हैं। गर्दन विश्राम कर रहा है, चेहरा ढीला पड़ रहा है, सिर का हिस्सा पूरी तरह से शिथिल हो चुका है। अब आप किसी ऐसी जगह को इमेजिन करें जहां पे कि आप आराम से विश्राम कर सकते हैं। ये कोई बीच हो सकता है, समंदर का किनारा हो सकता है, या ये कोई गार्डन हो सकता है। वहां आराम से लेट जाएं। इमेजिन करिए कि आप एक गार्डन में लेटे हुए हैं और यहां की ताजी हवा आपको और विश्राम दे रही है। तितलियां आपके आसपास उड़ रही हैं और जब आप इनको देखते हैं तो आपका मन शांत हो रहा है। ठंडी हवा के झोंके आपके शरीर को एक मसाज दे रहे हैं। नरम नरम घासों को अपने शरीर से छूते हुए महसूस करें। आप इस टेम्परेचर को इंजॉय कर रहे हैं और आपका मन एक गहन विश्राम में उतरता जा रहा है। जो भी तनाव आपके शरीर में था, इमेजिन करिए वो भाप की तरह आपके शरीर से उड़ता जा रहा है। आपका शरीर और ढीला पड़ रहा है, आपका मन और शांत हो रहा है। इस स्टेट में मैं आपको कुछ सजेशंस देता हूं। अपने मन में पूरे कन्विक्शन के साथ, पूरी दृढ़ता के साथ, पूरी मजबूती के साथ ये दोहराएं कि मैं शक्तिशाली हूं, आई एम पावरफुल। मैं शक्तिशाली हूं, आई एम पावरफुल। आई एम बिकमिंग हेल्दी, मैं स्वस्थ हो रहा हूं। आई एम बिकमिंग हेल्दी, मैं स्वस्थ हो रहा हूं। आई एम बिकमिंग रिच, मैं धनवान हो रहा हूं। मैं धनवान हो रहा हूं।
आई एम बिकमिंग सक्सेसफुल, मैं सफल बन रहा हूं। और इसी आनंद को महसूस करते हुए, इस रिलैक्सेशन का आनंद लेते हुए, ये जानते हुए कि ब्रह्मांड की सबसे बड़ी शक्ति आपके साथ हमेशा है और हमेशा रहेगी, अब आप वापस आने के लिए तैयार हैं। अब मैं 1 से 5 गिनूंगा, मेरे 5 गिनने के साथ साथ आप धीरे से अपनी आंखें खोलेंगे। 1, आसपास की आवाजों को सुनना शुरू करें। 2, अपने शरीर को थोड़ा थोड़ा हिलाना शुरू करें। 3, अपने पैरों को मोड़ लें। 4, अपने शरीर को हिलाएं डुलाएं। और 5,
raise both hands over the body, rub the palms against each other, place the warm hands over the eyes and face, cover the eyes under the palms, open and close 2 times, slide the hands over the face, turn the body towards one side, towards the right side, and stay on right for 2 seconds. And with help of both hands, very gently bring the body up back to the sitting posture. Yep. So we'll do couple of pranayams before we end the session. 9:34, but we'll try not to spend so much time. Make the Vishnu Mudra, roll first 2 fingers into root of thumb. We will do Chandra Bhedana Pranayam, a Chandra Nadi Pranayam. So we'll inhale and exhale from left side only. Inhale deeply from left and exhale from left. Complete when you breathe out from left. Next, we'll do Bhramari Pranayams. We'll do 3 times. Deep inhale, and we're gonna, with the closed mouth, we're gonna chant Makara, sound like B. Close the ears with the thumb tip. Close eyes and mouth. Thank you. नेक्स्ट वी विल डू अनुलोम विलोम प्राणायाम नाड़ी शुद्धि प्राणायाम विष्णु मुद्रा स्टार्ट फ्रॉम लेफ्ट ब्रीद इन फ्रॉम लेफ्ट ब्रीद आउट फ्रॉम राइट ब्रीद इन फ्रॉम राइट ब्रीद आउट फ्रॉम लेफ्ट लेफ्ट टू राइट टू लेफ्ट अल्टरनेट ब्रीदिंग You can add chanting to the breathing if you like. When you breathe out from left, conclude. Palms top of each other, sit straight, shoulders relaxed, close the eyes. We'll chant three Mahamrityunjaya mantra followed by meditation and prayer. So keep the eyes closed through the end. ॐ त्र्यम्बकं यजामहे सुगन्धिं पुष्टिवर्धनम् उर्वारुकमिव बन्धनान् मृत्योर्मोक्षयमामृतात् ॐ त्र्यम्बकं यजामहे सुगन्धिं पुष्टिवर्धनम् उर्वारुकमिव बन्धनान् मृत्योर्मोक्षयमामृतात् ॐ त्र्यम्बकं यजामहे सुगन्धिं पुष्टिवर्धनम् उर्वारुकमिव बन्धनान् मृत्योर्मोक्षयमामृतात् Both hands at chest. Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramaya. सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःख भाग् भवेत् ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः Spread the fingers over the face, head, shoulders, hands, the whole body. Slowly open the eyes. Okay, Jai Shri Krishna. થોડું શર્ષણાપુરું આજે લાંબુ ચાલ્યું થોડું,